What's up, people? This is Tanya, and welcome to Books, Incense, and Brown Liquor. I hope y'all are doing well. I'm doing fine myself. Anywho, today's video is my very first online book haul, okay? Because Lord knows I have plenty of books around here, but today is my first online book haul that I get to share with y'all. So I have 12 books that I got from bookoutlet.com. They don't know it, but they're my new best friend. And the other two books I got from Amazon, which is where I pretty much get all my books. So anyway, let's get into this video. So book number one, oh my God, I heard so much about this one. Three Dark Crowns by Kendare Blake. So basically, let me just read the back. I'm not going to say too much, but three dark queens are born in a glen. Sweet little triplets will never be friends. Three dark sisters, all fair to be seen, two to devour, and one to be queen. So basically, three sisters, and only one of them can be queen. And the last one left standing, that's the one who takes the crown. Damn. Sounds juicy. Okay, moving on. Okay, our next book is Waking Lions by Ayelet Gundar Goshen. Waking Lions. Basically, this is about a guy who is a doctor, and on his way home from work, he hits and kills someone, and since there are no witnesses, he just goes home thinking that he can get away with it. Well, he doesn't get away with it, because the man that he hit and killed, his wife shows up at his house the next day, and all I know is she expects payment and not in the form of money. That's all I know. Waking Lions. Oops. Sounds good to me. Right? This is called When the Moon Was Ours. Anna Marie McLemore. When the Moon Was Ours. I know absolutely nothing about what this... I know nothing. It sounded good at the time. I trust my decision. And this one is called All the Rage by Courtney Summers. From what I get of this girl, it seems like she was the victim of some type of crime or something. And it looks like, from the synopsis, it sounds like the sheriff's son did her wrong in some way. But he's like the town golden boy, so I don't think anyone is on her side. That's all I know. I trust my decision. I'll let you know when I read it. Broken Beautiful Hearts by Cami Garcia. Oh, you can see, look at, you can see the glare in that joint. Broken Beautiful Hearts by Cami Garcia. Now, I've never read any of Cami Garcia's books, but I got this book recommendation from Naya Reads and Smiles, because she's so adorable, and who wouldn't follow any of her book recommendations. She spoke highly of this one, and when I read the synopsis, let me give you a little snippet. When star soccer player Peyton Rios receives an offer from her first choice college, her senior year starts off exactly as planned, until she uncovers her boyfriend's dark secret. Peyton confronts him and finds herself falling down a flight of stairs. Her knee and possibly her dream of going pro is shattered. That's all I'm gonna say. Okay, so this, Baylor's Guide to Dreadful Dreams by Robert Emfeld. Basically, this boy, he can enter other people's dreams. And yeah, that's all I got. And the thing is, this is a kid's book. This is a middle grade fiction book, ages 10 to 14. But as you know, I read middle grade fiction too, because I like the magic of kids' stories. They're not too heavy yet. Oh, okay, so this. Before the Devil Breaks You by Liba Bray. First of all, you already know, this is book three of the Diviners series. You know, I love books with magic and mysticism, and first of all, I haven't even read the first two books. But Thanks to audible.com. I will be getting to that shortly. So anyway, Before the Devil Breaks You. Just the title alone is like, Okay. The Last Magician. You see how beautiful this cover is? Who wrote this? Lisa Maxwell. The Last Magician. Did I say magician? The Last Magician. You know what I have a problem with? Who the hell would put a sticker right on the front of this beautiful cover? What is wrong with you? Who does this? Who does this? I got issues with price tags being in the wrong places because it's just interrupting the flow. You see the snake being devoured by another snake? And you got this price tag right here just messing up the flow of things? Like, who raised you? Who does this? Okay, next we have The Damned by Andrew Piper. Okay, now, this shit sounded good. Basically, most people who have a near-death experience come back alone. Basically, him and his sister were in a fire, and she did not make it. He died and came back, and he did not come back alone. That's all I'm gonna say. That's just the right amount of creepy to reel me right on in. Touching Spirit Bear. Touching Spirit Bear by Ben Michelson. This is another middle grade fiction. Basically, this is about a boy who has issues controlling his anger. And one day his anger goes too far and he ends up putting someone in the hospital. And they're basically fighting for their lives. And so he's basically headed toward jail. But the only alternative is Cole is offered circle justice. It's a system based on Native American traditions that attempts to provide healing for the criminal offender. That's all I know. But Touching Spirit Bear, it sounded good to me. Look at the cover. Right. Okay. Hold up. Okay, I'm coming. Woo! How to Hang a Witch by Adriana Mather. Okay, so let me tell you, for those of y'all that are familiar with the Salem witch trials and Salem witch burnings, this is a story about a girl named Samantha Mather. She just moved to Salem. And basically, her great, I don't know how many greats, but her great-grandfather was responsible for the witch huntings and the witch burnings. And they're referring to Cotton Mather. And if any of you have watched the show Salem on, I forget what network, but if you just Google Cotton Mather, there's like a whole bunch of history on him. He was like basically the main person responsible for the witch trials in Salem. So she is supposed to be his descendant. And yeah, sounds interesting. So yeah, How to Hang a Witch. Okay, and then my last book, outlet.com book, I got this book recommendation from Nair Reads and Smiles, and it sounds so good once I read what it was about. Flame in the Mist by Renee Adjaye. Yeah. Look at that. Even the cover is pretty. It's about a girl who basically she's the daughter of a prominent samurai. And during this time frame, women were basically born just to marry. So I think she's supposed to be like, she's on her way to meet her betrothed because back then they had like arranged marriages, and she ends up getting caught up in some type of kidnapping or whatever. And that's all I know, but it sounded good at the time. I trust my decision. And my last two books. Black Enough, Stories of Being Young and Black in America, edited by E.B. Zaboy. But it's basically a book of short stories all about the Black American experience. Lord knows I can relate. So I'm just, my curiosity got the best of me with this one. Everybody's talking about this book, Black Enough. So you know what, let me find out and I'll get back to you with my thoughts and opinions. And my last book, The Devouring Gray. Yes, I fell for the hype. Everybody and their mother is talking about this book. It wasn't even on my TBR, but I'm not even gonna lie, I cheated and read some of it, even though I'm already reading something else. But I cheated and I read up to page 92 because I wanted to see if it lived up to all of the hype. You got magic, you got a creature that lives in the woods. The woods is kind of like, it kind of reminds you of Stranger Things. It reminds you of like, but they don't, instead of calling it the upside down, they call it the gray. And then you got the four families that are supposed to keep the town safe. And that's all I know right now. Is it living up to the hype? I'm intrigued. I'm enjoying the ride. I'll give it that. But I want to say this author, Christine Lynn Herman. I just want to show you real quick. And I just thought this was funny. Look at her picture. Doesn't she remind you of Tuesday Addams from the Addams Family? And I mean that as a compliment, because Tuesday Addams was TV's first goth girl. And I love that. Tuesday Addams. But anyway, so far I'm enjoying this. And I, once I'm done, I'll probably do like a book review, because it's good and creepy and intriguing. It's easy to read. It's not too intricate or whatever. Not too many big words. And then the one last thing I have is an incense that I want to talk about. The Galaxy. And this is made by him. Can you see? I know I'm getting so much glare. Okay, first of all, I bought this months ago as part of like the Galaxy group of incense. It came with sun, moon, star, planet, and galaxy. This one kind of got tossed to the side because I was so concerned about the sun and the moon. This one I kind of like put in my closet. And then I took it out and burnt it the other day. You know how like you underestimate something, you put it in the back of the closet and then you burn it and you're like, oh shit, I was asleep. But anyway, Galaxy by Hem. It's like woodsy, resiny, with a hint of floral. So I highly recommend. So anyway, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for hanging in with me on my very first book haul. Let me know, comment below. Let me know if you've read any of these books. I would love to hear your feedback. And thank you for watching. Y'all have a good day. Oh, I wish you good reading.